your conversation. I'm learning more and more each day. And I know our audience really are going to be satisfied when they hear you and dying to meet you, because you are a good trainer. Your personality shows you care. And that's very, very important when you're working with someone, because you have to be able to take constructive criticism, you know. And then you have to be able to get over a lot of your own hang-ups that you can't do or you need to do, and trying. So, you know, it's good that your personality is the biggest thing about what we need to do. And I really appreciate you. And I see you at the gym. Everybody appreciates you.
Thank you.
So your personality has a lot to do helping us to be better people. And thank you. So, Natalie, what have you gotten from Tyrone? Because I've been trying to get you to get him to train you.
One thing I like is details. And when he explained about the dehydration, and I didn't realize that when dehydration is a silent killer, that my light bulb went up, because I know that I should be drinking at least 6 bottles of water a day. And then he mentioned to one of the audience members about working on the core, and you're very detailed, and you're like you start from the foundation and build up. You don't just throw us in there, and it makes me want to get more involved, you know. I'm an advocate of health and fitness since I was 18. I'm 59 years old now, young, and I want to get back in shape. I said in 10 years, I'll be, or in 1 year, I'll be in better shape, or one year, I'll be in worse shape. Which is it? When I turn 60, what I want to be? In better shape at age 60, or in worse shape at age 60? So.
And Stacy?
I think the biggest thing for me is the passion behind everything that he does. That's what brings me back. So I know when I go there, I feel comfortable. He pushes me, but he doesn't over push. And he has great expectations for you, and high expectations. So I like that. I like that.
Your goal,
and then the knowledge behind everything too.
Yeah, that knowledge, right. And the personality, because I get there sometimes 8:30, and I don't leave till 11:30. Say all these hours, but just to sit there and watch him, interacts with the other people about anything, you know, and how they come in and speak, and how he.
And the explanation behind everything. Sometimes people tell you to do, and you don't know why.
Communication.
Right.
Is the key. It's listening.
And what the reason is. You know what I mean? And he breaks down a lot, especially me in my situation. Like, he breaks down a lot of why I need to do what he's doing with me. And why I need to continue doing it when I get home, my homework.
What really gets me, how he sneaks up, because we be back there, we still be on the bicycle, right? And we just talking.
He's like, what y'all doing? Y'all here to work out? Or we talking? What are we doing? Right. Girl time?
Yeah, he sneaks up on you. He scares me, right?
Why?
Because we don't know you're there.
Well, you come out
of the back. You sound like a ninja.
Yeah. And just like he's trying to catch us doing something wrong.
I got off the bike one time. I was getting ready to go up front and say, you know what, I'm ready for round two. He's sitting right there on the bike. I'm like, well, I'm going to just slide in. He's like, I'm always around. I see.
Keep you on your toes.
Yes, yeah. He does.
Just checking personalities. That's all.
Right.
But it helps. It really, it really does. Helps. It
pushes us.
Yeah. So I enjoy being there 3 days a week, you know, and watching him and watching how he teaches others. And I'm learning at the same time.
Right.
So that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. That makes him even better at his job.
You know? Takes his time, and he builds you up for the next. So he always tells you what you're in for the next workout, or what you're going to be doing the next time around, or what we're working up to. So it's always something to look forward to.
What I actually need my own self, because I was in a car accident 2 years ago. And I always say, I know what I need to do, but got to get up and do it.
Right.
And that's where a personal trainer can come in.
Yeah.
We provide the foot. Sometimes you need a foot.
Yeah, what you do with that foot?
Foot.
And put it where?
Where it have, where it's most effective.
Yes, but staying in shape, because I think most everybody in my family smoked. My father died when I was 16, and of his seven children, five of us smoked. And I'm the first one to start. I started at 14. But everybody else is dead. They died much younger. None of them has lived as long as I have lived right now. My father died. He was, 39.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, 49. Wow. And my two brothers, 49. One sister in the 60s, I think, 50s. One sister in the 50s and another sister 60. And I kept, after they got sick, I kept on smoking. I'm not even going to go to the story when I succumbed, but I almost died then, you know, because it seemed like the voice says, I thought you was going to stop smoking. I had taken my youngest sister who was smoking, her day out in the wheelchair, first day out in the wheelchair, and I'm the big sister, so I'm going to make sure that she's not going to be a punk out here because she's in a wheelchair, you know. So I'm with her. When we got on the bus to go downtown Newark, I got in the front, she in the back like we wasn't, you know, by ourselves. And for a minute, she forgot that she was with me. And we was downtown, we went all downtown, went down to see Dolly, Legal Services, we went here, we went shopping, we ate. And after I eat, you know, I want a cigarette. And we was in the old Woolworth. And well, if I get a negative thought, I say it's the devil. Positive thought is God. And the devil says, Jihadad, you haven't had a cigarette since you left the house this morning. It's time for your cigarette break. Then the positive thought, that's God, says, you've been trying to stop. Use this time to stop. The negative thought says, F him. Excuse the thought. But you know, the negative thought.
Yeah.
You know, he always in my business. You know, go ahead, you earned it. And I went out and I smoked a cigarette. No, the positive thought says, what must I do to make you realize it's time to give that up? Bring you to your knees? He ain't gonna do nothing. He always trying to scare somebody. That's how the devil does, negative thought. Mm-hmm. And I went outside and brought a Lucy, nasty tasting cigarette. The next day, I was on my knees. Jackie White came all the way from Edison, and I'm two blocks from East Orange General. And she dropped me off at the emergency, parked the car, came in, looked to her right, and I'm still sitting here dying.
Trying to catch your next breath, you said.
Right, we're dying.
Yeah.
And wow. She started to come. But then she went to this door. She almost kicked it down. She works up at St. Barnabas at the time. And she threw her credentials on the desk. She said, they was out there playing cards and talking and carrying on. We got a whole room full of patients in emergency. This is what happens in emergency. And she says, you got a 60-some-year-old woman out there with upper respiratory. Not only will I have your job, I have your head. So they hurry up and got me in. And then they got me in the bed and got some air going through me. Then the positive thought says, now do I have your attention? Mm-hmm. And I said, yeah, Lord, what do you want me to do? He said, first, you have to let me heal you. But they couldn't understand what that meant, you know? But they couldn't understand either why I was not taking their medicine. And they wanted me out of there, but I wasn't leaving because I knew if I went home, I would smoke again because everybody in the building, you smell it, that turns you on, you want a cigarette. And I wouldn't leave, but I'm a certified nurse's aide, and I was bossing the people around. They were sick of me. So they went and got another psychiatrist, and then they got to chase them down home because, you want some drugs? I get you some drugs. You know, that's how they treat us. You know, they, we're all junkies. So I chased them down the hall. Then they brought this little woman in there, and she's standing up there, and she already heard about me. And she's going to talk to me. I said, you going to talk to me? You're not going to stand over me and talk to me. If you're going to talk to me, you're going to sit your little butt down right over there. And she back there. I says, you know the psychology in this country doesn't work. She said, huh? I said, no, it doesn't work. I said, if it did, you wouldn't have all these crazy people running around here. Put a book down, walked out. Then they put me in a hotel for a month. Evergreen. Everybody, how did you get here? You know? They did that to get rid of me. But I stopped smoking. But what really saved me before you, I used to always walk. Even when I was driving, I would park the car. I always loved to walk. I'm a people person. I like to talk to people, stop and talk to people, get on the bus. Because people say, how do you meet people? I said, on the bus. You still take the bus. Love the bus. You love it, don't you?
I have a lot of bus drivers that I train.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Love it.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm a people person, too.
Yeah, so, you know, the outdoors, and I always walked and did this and stopped, even in the supermarket, you know. I'm talking and telling people, oh, you don't need that. Buy this. And then I tell this person, don't be buying all this fat food. And then I said, now come over here and stop me from getting all this ice cream. I love ice cream, you know. But I did walk, and that saved me. That kept me in shape from the walking. So when you talk about walking earlier, I know. I used to walk all over. I used to pass an advertisement, and it's a lot of walking. I used to go into projects, and I walk all the way down and all the way back up. So I did a lot of walking and walking the steps, and I used to love to jump rope. That's what you promised to get me to do again.
Yep.
Jumping rope. So I'm gonna do that. So you said you had another question you would like to ask Tyra?
And I think that one of the audience members wanted some questions. Me? I have lots of questions, but I want to give somebody else a chance too as well.
Okay.
But basically, yes, just hearing your conversation with the other questions answered my questions already.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm just excited now to maybe possibly start getting some personal training done my own self, in the future.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Please, because I want to see you do that split again.
I can still do the split now.
Yeah,
don't get it twisted. No, but still. But people always say, oh, you still look good, Natalie, but still, you. Fat cells, like when I lost that 15 pounds, I lost 15 pounds of fat. You can lose water, you don't lose any muscle, because muscles weighs more than fat. See, but I want to get myself in healthy shape, not just be looking good, healthier. Because your core, when you have a lot of fat around your core, that's very unhealthy. It can cause diabetes. It's visceral fat. It can cause your organs, it can leach into your organs, So, I need motivation. See, I'm a great speaker. But right now, I like to be able to be like the trainer. See the trainer right here? He talks and walks the walk.
You have to.
Yeah.
So, we're fortunate to have you and start at such a young age. If we could get our children, and he don't realize what we plan to do with children, and I'm going to use them, he don't realize it's a bigger picture here. Mm. I don't want to surprise you, but... You've been hooked. So we have some plans for you, especially working with the children.
Yeah.
Okay, so Mr. Good, you have another question for us?
I have a question. Can you tell me, it's a couple of questions. One, if a person is trying to lose weight, should they be counting calories?
You have to. As a trainer, we learn the law of thermodynamics. If you want to lose weight, you eat less than you, the law of thermodynamics, if you want to gain weight, you eat more than you exercise. If you want to lose weight, you eat less than you exercise. That way you force your body to burn the reserve fat that you have stored.
So realistically, someone, for example, that weighs, 200 pounds,
mm-hmm.
and they want to lose 30 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
Realistically, how many calories would you suggest that they eat per day?
Everyone is different. And online, they have calculators, right, where you put your weight in, your height, your age, and it'll calculate your normal. I mean,